Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. Students, in this video I am going to talk to 7th standard students. Students, we have been talking about 7th chapter, electricity, current and its effects. Students, in the last class we have talked about an introduction related to the chapter. What was the introduction, you know? Introduction was that two students were sitting in their study room and studying, and suddenly power went off. Then what did they do? They searched for light, and immediately the boy took two battery cells from his table desk and he tries to insert the battery cells into the torch, and finally they inserted the battery cells into the torch light and they got the light. Okay, that was the introduction. And also I taught you about make your own cell. That was an experiment. You know, I taught you only the introduction part of that experiment, and in this video I would like to teach you about complete process of making your own cell. And what is the aim of your experiment there? Your aim is what is your aim? First of all, you have to put heading lab activity. Lab activity. What is your task here? Aim. Aim is to make your own cell, and operators what operators do you require here? You require to injection bottles, one LED light, one copper strip, one zinc strip, and few bits of copper wires. Students, these are the operators that you require to make your own cell. Okay students, now what's the side heading? Next procedure. What you should follow? A procedure to make your own cell. First of all, you have to take two injection bottles. Okay, I am not writing all the matter here. Students, I am not writing all the matter here. I just explain by showing these operators here. First of all, you should take two injection bottles, and then you have to take copper strip and zinc strip. Students, here you have to take one copper strip and one zinc strip, and then you have to take one more important chemical, that's sulfuric acid. What is this? Sulfuric acid. Here I just draw the diagram and explain. Students, you can see here one injection bottle, yeah, and you have to take 3/4 of or liquid in this. What is that liquid here? This is this one, injection bottle. Sorry, this is sulfuric acid. And here,
rubber stopper.
What will be there? Rubber stopper. Here, the rubber stoppers will be like this for injection bottles. Then you have to take one copper strip, insert the copper strip into the injection bottle like this, and here also insert copper strip into injection bottle like this, and see that the base of the copper strip should dip into the sulfuric acid, and then zinc strip as well. Take zinc strip and do the same like this. You know how you did for copper strip, same like that you have to do for zinc strip. What is this? Copper strip. And what is this? Zinc strip. Same like this for another injection bottle. This injection bottle 1 and this injection bottle 2. Now, what you have to take? Now, take one LED bulb. And you have to see that injection, sorry, that LED bulb is with two terminals. What are these? Terminals. One is plus terminal, another one is minus terminal. Positive terminal and negative terminal. Okay, what is this? LED bulb. LED light. Then what you have to do is, you have to take bits of copper wires. You have to take bits of copper wires and then you have to connect one copper wire to positive terminal of the one bit of copper wire to the positive terminal of LED bulb and another bit of copper wire to negative terminal of the LED bulb. Okay, here. And where you should connect these terminal wires? You have to connect these terminal wires. You know, this is copper, this is zinc. This is copper and this is zinc. Now you have to connect this terminal copper wire to this zinc strip here and this copper wire terminal to the copper strip here. Okay, this is the connection. And then this copper and zinc terminals are here free, no? Then you have to connect these two terminals also with the copper wire. You take another bit of copper wire and you have to connect this zinc terminal and copper terminal of strips like this. Okay, you have to connect. Then you have to observe the light. Now, observation. What is your observation there? Will you see the LED bulb lights up? Definitely. You know, here, there you need to follow some precautions. You know, you should see that the copper and zinc strip should immerse into the acid. What acid? Sulfuric acid. And you should see that to immerse the copper and zinc strips into the sulfuric acid, same like that in two injection bottles. And then before you insert this copper and zinc strips into this injection bottles, you should scrape off what you have to. For example, this is copper strip here. This end and this end should be scraped with a sandpaper. With a what? Sandpaper. Why to scrape it? Why to scrape it means there may be some formation of carbon. There may be some formation of carbon on the surface of these strips. If there is some carbon matter formed on the copper strip or zinc strip like this, what will happen, you know? That carbon formation acts like insulator. So, there will be no passage of current. So here, how current is produced here, that is the main concept. How current is produced here? Acid is there, no? This acid reacts with the copper and zinc strips and they produce some ions. They produce some what? Ions. So the ions are like positive ions and negative ions. You know, positive ions and negative ions. These ions are nothing but charges. Positive charge and negative charge. So these ions, they move towards copper and zinc strips sides. And positive ions move towards copper strip side and negative ions move towards zinc strip side. Then what will happen, you know, they start moving through the copper strip and copper wire and through the LED bulb and then again this zinc strip and again into this sulfuric acid and again copper, like this, you know, there will be flow of what? Of charges. There will be what? Flow of charges. Remember this word, students. Flow of charges. When the flow of these charges there in these strips and copper wires to make this light glow, then there you can understand there will be circuit. Okay, of charges, circuit of charges. Where there is circuit of charges, that means the flow of charges, the light glows up. Otherwise, if you disconnect, see, once you disconnect this copper wire and this copper strip here, or else you disconnect anywhere, you just disconnect at any point of this flow of charges, then you observe the light. Will the light glow? No. If you disconnect any wire or any this connections, any one of these connections at any point of these wires or at any place, if you disconnect, the flow of charges will get broken and then there will be no flow of charges, there will be no circuit charges, and then the light will not glow. So again you try to connect it and you observe. Will the light glow then?
Yes, sir.
Obviously, light glows. So this is how you can understand how you can make your own battery cell. Okay, students. This is how you can understand how you can make your own battery cell. So how I explained here, you have to put it in a sentence form and present it in our WhatsApp group, students. Thank you. Thank you for listening and thank you one and all.